Good evening, sir.
Good evening, you're welcome.
Please, can you tell us your name, sir?
I'm Comrade Abdullateef Ishowo, public affairs analyst and an author based in LA.
So, we have some questions for you on the Not Too Young to Run Bill that just passed in the 8th Senate. So, please, are you ready to?
You're welcome. Please go ahead.
As an activist and concerned Nigerian, what is your take on Not Too Young to Run Bill?
Well, thank you for that question. It's one of the most topical questions in Nigeria now because it is on the pages of several newspapers across Nigeria, and even outside Nigeria people are talking about it. I was watching CNN last night where it was brought forward for discussion. So it is a topical issue now that we should talk about, and I think we should support the National Assembly this time around because it is long overdue. I believe it should have come even decades before now. Probably simply because our democracy or democratic journey is just 17 years now. I mean, uninterrupted democratic system of government since 1999. So the military intercession has affected the democratization process of the country, and that's why we are talking about that now. But I do always tell people that the reason why we should support it is that whenever I had the opportunity of speaking about the youth, is that those that built Nigeria from the beginning were a crop of youth. Talk of Awolowo, talk of Nnamdi Azikiwe, talk of Ahmad Bello. You need to ask yourself, how old were they when they were ruling Nigeria? Wole Soyinka got into limelight at the age of 30 when he wrote his book, The Lion and the Jewel. Chinua Achebe was just 28 in 1958 when he wrote it. Akubuwon was just 31 in 1966. So how old was JTU Agbenrose? How old was Ojukwu? These were people that were ruling Nigeria at that time. In fact, Matthew Umbu was just 26 when he became federal minister in 1956. Shagari himself, 1959 when he became federal minister, was just like above 30. So even Buhari, that is governing us now, in 1975, when he became the governor of Borno, he was just 33. So when you look at it, the people that built Nigeria at the beginning were crops of youth. So that we are not talking about not too young to run means that something was wrong, that there was a break in between the youth that were ruling Nigeria and the leaders that are currently ruling Nigeria. When they say corruption, 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 I tell people that the people that are corrupt in Nigeria today, that are siphoning our money and that are taking Nigeria to where we are now, are old people, or let me say people that are not belonging to the youth folk. Because the people that built Nigeria at the beginning, that we always refer to as the founding fathers, were youth. So now that we have 70-something, 60-something, 50-something ruling Nigeria, we are talking about corruption. So the Not Too Young to Run Bill is a welcome development. Only if leaders in Nigeria we identify the fact that it is youth power should be returned to, they should play background role of, advisory role. In the whole of Africa, at the beginning, we need to ask, Haile Selassie became leader of I can't remember his country now, of Ethiopia, at the age of 21, for God's sake. What about Nkrumah of Ghana? What about Julius Nyerere of Tanzania? And so on and so forth. They were a set of youths that fought the colonial masters to regain the freedom for African countries. How come today that we have so relegated the youth to the background, we are now facing challenges in governance and development? So Not Too Young to Run Bill is a welcome development, and it is a forerunner to challenging or to spur the youth towards identifying the fact that I'm not too young to govern after all. So the youth that are becoming so relented should now gear up that after all, it is through me Nigeria can get to the desired or Eldorado.
Okay. Yeah, you are telling us that Not Too Young to Run Bill is a welcome development.
It's a very welcome development, sir. No bill without their own itches. When we suspect because we run the system of governance in Nigeria on mutual suspicion between leaders and the led. So maybe suspecting them, probably they are planning this for their own children. The fact that it will live even after them will bring about strong institutions to the National Assembly And in fact, not only all their children will be qualified to contest. I will be qualified. I said this in a media platform this morning that though the not too young to run does not really favor me, because there is no age according to the Nigerian constitution that there's no position in there I cannot contest. But at least the younger generation, people that Wole Soyinka time.